So let us look at a reformulation of the Huber estimation problem. Earlier we have seen the outlier contamination model, and we have seen two different formulations to handle outliers in linear models. We have seen the lasso-like formulation, which is P1, which involves minimizing the residuals after removing the outliers, as well as the L1 norm of the outliers. And we have seen the Huber estimation problem, which involves minimizing the Huber penalty on the residuals. The claim is that these problems, these formulations P1 and P2, are actually equivalent. Now to see that, let us begin by considering the first formulation. So let us write it as minimization of XO, and let's expand this part. So I equal to 1 to m yi minus ai transpose x minus oi square plus lambda times absolute value of oi. So I'm putting this summation over the whole thing. So this is the problem statement. Now this is minimization with respect to x and o both, but observe that there are no constraints on o, and the problem is actually separable in each of the ois. So the problem can be written as minimization over x, and then the minimization with respect to o can be taken inside. So what we can say is that minimization over x, summation over I from 1 to m, minimization over oi, and then the objective function, which is yi minus ai transpose x minus oi square plus lambda times absolute value of oi. So this is another way of writing the same problem. Now observe that if we solve this, which is that we minimize this with respect to oi and substitute the minimum value back, then we will get a function of x, right? So we will no longer have oi with us. So in other words, oi would have to be eliminated, right? So this is elimination of oi essentially. Now if we consider this function as a function of y minus ai transpose x, oi has been eliminated, so this is only a function of x. So we can call it as rho I of x. Now what is rho I of x? So what is rho I of x? In particular, we are interested in seeing how rho I of x depends on x. Note that in rho I of x, x appears only in the form of ai transpose x. In fact, yi minus ai transpose x is the only dependence. So rho I of x is essentially some function of yi minus ai transpose x, and this function itself, h itself, does not depend on I, because the I dependence is only through y and a. So let us try to find out the form of this function h, and in fact we will prove that h is exactly the Huber function. So let's see how to solve this problem. So we are essentially now solving this problem. So let's say that ri is equal to yi minus ai transpose x. So we are interested in solving this problem. Minimize oi, and the constraint is ri minus oi plus square plus lambda times oi. Now do we know how to solve this problem? This problem is not very difficult to solve. All we need to do is divide O into several cases, and then we should be able to solve them. So let's say that case one is, we don't know what OI is, but let's assume anyway that the solution of this OI is positive, right? So the solution of this is that OI which is positive. Let's assume. If this assumption is not true, then we will assume the other thing, that OI is negative. So if OI is positive, this problem would basically be written as minimize over oi positive ri minus oi square plus lambda times oi, and this is a simple quadratic problem. So oi star here would be equal to ri minus lambda by 2, so basically positive part, right? So essentially we will get, if we solve this quadratic problem, we would get ri minus lambda by 2. But this is only valid when oi is positive, because we assume that oi is positive. So this is only valid when ri is greater than lambda by 2. So it will basically be 0 otherwise. Right? So oi star is equal to this quantity. In the same way, if we assume that oi is less than 0, then we can solve the problem oi less than 0, ri minus oi square minus lambda times oi. So oi star in this case would be ri plus lambda by 2, provided that ri plus lambda by 2 is actually negative, and it would be 0 otherwise. If this quantity is positive, it would be 0. So let's substitute this and this value back. So what would be obtained? Note that these two cases depend on what ri is. If actually ri is greater than lambda by 2, then this case would apply. And if ri is less than minus lambda by 2, then this case would apply. So there is no possibility of these two cases overlapping. In fact, just by looking at ri, you would know which case is going to apply. So if we substitute it back, we would obtain rho I of x, which, if you can remember, is h of ri equal to lambda absolute value of ri minus lambda square by 4 whenever ri absolute value of ri is greater than lambda by 2, and ri square when absolute value of ri is less than equal to lambda by 2. So this is exactly, as you can see, this is exactly the Huber function for a specific case where basically you have to take m equal to lambda by 2. So this is basically h of lambda by 2 of ri. So in summary, we have seen that the least square or the lasso-like formulation for removing the outlier contaminations can be converted by elimination of OI into the Huber function formulation. So this is an interesting connection between a very classical estimator, which is the Huber estimator, and all the theory about M estimators and robust estimators built around Huber estimation, and the modern use of L1 norm minimization for encouraging sparsity.